Hi, good evening. How are you doing? It's Jim. It's Sunday. And it's that time of the week where you just want us to take things down a bit, chill out, for want of a better word. It's kind of a crap way to sort of describe it, isn't it? Chill out. But you want to just, it's Sunday. It's end of the weekend, a little glass of beer before the week starts up, before we sort of launch into all that crap that you've been trying to put off and forget about. Your calendar and your phone keeps sending you reminders of all this crap that's about to happen and to sort of take over your life for the next 5 days. Appointments, things to do, emails to send, people to talk to, phone calls to make, all that stuff. It's still a few hours away. The rest of the house is gone to bed. It's late in the evening. Got a few hours, an hour. I want to listen to a bit of music, just chill out. And what I thought I'd like to listen to this evening is actually, although I have this, I bought this not very long ago. This is Devin Townsend, Acoustically Inclined, live in Leeds. I have listened to sides one and two, but I've not got any further than that. So I'd like to listen, and I'm probably only going to do side three on video. But it's Love, which is from his previous band, Strapping Young Lad. It's extreme metal, so I'm not quite sure how this is going to translate into an acoustic environment. So that's interesting. We've got Hyperdrive, which is that could work. That's from Ziltoid the Omniscient, and that's a whole other thing. Which at some point I might do a video about on YouTube, which is it's a concept album, very much a concept album of comedic proportions and of metallic proportions, about an alien called Ziltoid who attacks the Earth in search of the ultimate cup of coffee. Now, it may sound ridiculous, and indeed it is, but it's hugely great fun, and it doesn't take itself seriously at all, and the music is just brilliant. It's brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. Anyway, so that song, Hyperdrive, is from Ziltoid the Omniscient. And then the final song on the side is called Terminal, which I think is from Key. I can't remember, but I'll recognise it when I get to it. I think that's from Key. And if so, I know that'll work well, because Key's, although not acoustic, it's a fairly stripped back album. So I think that'll work well. This was put out by Devin Townsend this year in 2021. In response, I guess, to not being able to get out there and tour and to make a living. So it's going back to 2019. This was a short tour that he did. I don't know if it was just the UK or whether it was around Europe, but before he launched on the whole Empath full band tour, he did these acoustic shows, and this is a recording of one of them, live in Leeds, which is a city in the north of England. It's been put out on vinyl. I've listened to sides one and two, which I've already said, which are absolutely phenomenal. And what I love about this is it's just such a absolute juxtaposition to what you might expect Devin Townsend to sound like. So if you are a casual listener and have heard odd bits of Devin Townsend here and there, you're probably well aware of his vocal ability and acrobatics, the crushing sound of the guitar and the drums, and the sort of this full-on wall of sound metal that he is famed for. But as I've tried to explain to some friends of mine before, he's kind of so much more than that. That's just like scratching the surface of what he can and does do. So that he's released this acoustic album is just brilliant. And he's done this before. There was an acoustic album came out I don't know when it was. I haven't actually got it, but that was came out quite a long time ago, which was a selection of these tracks from his catalogue, which he performed acoustically. And if you have any interest and have followed his career at all, which I come over as some sort of as if I'm sort of, you know, all-knowing sort of expert on Devin Townsend. I'm not. I've only known about this guy for 3 years, three and a bit years. So it's all still reasonably new to me. But I kind of have researched, and I've sort of dug into what he's doing, and have I have invested in him, because I really, really, really think that he's a really, truly great artist. A few weeks ago, I made a video about listening to Casualties of Cool, which is a record he put out with Shay Amy Dorville, which is sort of like an Americana country album. Again, so far removed from what people expected him to be doing, if you only ever know him as this sort of as a metal guy. There are some people only know him as this sort of bluesy, rootsy guy who had no idea about the metal side. There are people who know him as like, sort of like ambient electronica guy, because he does that as well. I mean, there's just so much stuff to him, so many layers, and it's such a sort of a complex, interesting composer and performer and musician from that point of view, that you just sort of I just find it fascinating that there is just so much music in him that is presented. Anyway, look, I'm rambling. So let's crack on. This is side three from Acoustically Inclined in Leeds. The vinyl's lined up. We're going to start off with Love, then we have Hyperdrive, and then Terminal. So let's make sure we've got QuickTime recording, which we do. I think we're ready to go. I'll see you on the other side.
Three, two, one. Yeah, you see, now I just don't feel super positive. For a minute there, I did. But now, curse is to... curse is to be Safina! Doom must hear, and then all come, and together we enunciate words. Get your fucking lips wrapped around your sentiment, Townsend. No! Verily, yea, we stare into the void and say with a sonorous tone of voice, eat all the dicks.
Okay. Massive. I mean, I know he's famed for this wall of sound, but even with an acoustic guitar, there's a little reverb and the delay on that is humongous. This is so good. I'm loving this interpretation. Absolutely brilliant. Listen to the sound.
Oh, yeah!
But why? 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 No answer immediately springs to mind, so I just say again in a full tone of voice, why not? I guess I'll just wait for the night to come home.
Oh, God almighty, this is so good. Lovely to hear how close he is to the audience and what a rapport he's got with the.
Do you want to go home? Yeah, I kind of want to go home, but what's the thing is the thing you get back there and it's the same fucking problems. You always romanticize it. It's a thing every fucking time, and then you think it's going to be one thing and it's another thing, and it's a litany of problems in one way, and then when you're out here again, it's other problems. But yeah, I think it's just your biggest thing is just a whiner. You just like to fucking complain because on some level it feeds the creative process. Jesus, is that the case? Oh, you motherfucker. Holy fuck, that sucks. Oh my god, I think I'm in love!
Feels like such a genuinely live performance. I mean, it obviously it is, but I love that, the interaction and the sort of the back and forth and the conversation.
So
and
in
the ad-libbing
and think
the mistakes.
My son was born, no, 2006.
Okay, let's carry on.
And at that point, and it was a Saturday, the 27th. Huh? Fuck yeah. But at that point, I was trying to figure out, like, the whole strapping thing, because I just quit the band, and I was just like, oh, my God, this part of my personality that is personified in this type of music is something that is clearly an aberration, and I got to try and fix it because it's a problem within me. And at that point, we were surrounded by Teletubbies and Boobahs and, like, Mr. Blobby. That was the other one, right? But
that's my life
the
now.
The whole time I was thinking, okay, well, how do I deal with this? So I thought, well, clearly any rational human male would want to make a hand puppet out of it and then personify that part of his creative identity in terms of a thing that you can then objectify and make fun of in a sense that's safer in a way.
Okay, so you're explaining Ziltoid.
And then glue your fucking hair on it. So I remember my mom coming over one day. And she was just like, yeah, you might just not ever want to do this publicly. And I was like, ah, well, too late. So this was the first song written from the Ziltoid first record. Probably about how, but you know.
Context of the album, the individual songs are, I mean, the album is strong anyway, it's such a great record, but this doesn't sound like it's part of this sort of a parody record. It is a serious, properly good song, and he's played this routinely throughout his career ever since then, and every single set probably he's ever played.
Been to an acoustic gig,
you know, as a maybe the sort of the support act to the main band, or the whole gig has been an acoustic thing, maybe an afternoon gig at a pub or something like that, and it's just you can like it for one or two songs, but you just sort of tune out at the end because he's his background music is it's not that good. This, when it's done as well as this. I don't know, the songs are super strong. If I was, I'm going back sort of like 10 years ago, longer ago than that, 13, 14 years ago when I was in my old band, you may have seen the video for it, and we were doing gigs around East Anglia in the UK, and we played in the waterfront in Norwich, and we played in the Arts Centre in Colchester, and Ipswich, and all these other places. And, you know, we played a charity gigs, different pubs, and there'd be acoustic sets. And you thought, it's all just so samey and dull and boring. Why can't bands be as good as this when they do it? This is what elevates truly great performers and musicians, lifts them out of that sort of level where there's a million other people exactly the same. I don't know, is it the brilliance of the song? Is it the personality? Is it the performance, the singing? Is it a mixture of all of it? This is almost like, oh man, it's like a whole new version of these songs. This is, it's brilliant. Is this not the most beautiful music you've heard today?
Just leave her.
Oh.
Very, very fast played out. That's the end. I am absolutely going to leave it there for tonight for this video. Oh, what a beautiful, beautiful thing this is. I love it. Absolutely love this. And I loved it when I first heard the size 1 and 2. And I just didn't have the time at the time to carry on listening to the record. And then other stuff happened and I ended up listening to other things. I completely forgot about it. And I just suddenly realised tonight, it's a Sunday, as I said earlier on, it's a Sunday night. I just want to have a nice, chilled out, half an hour, end of the evening, listen to something sort of before the craziness of the week ahead starts up again. And just beautiful. I can't speak highly enough about this. I really can't. He might not like it. I mean, that's fair enough. If you don't like it, you don't like it. I'll tell you what. Dislike this video, because I'm all about that at the minute. Dislikes and likes and stuff. It's a thing, apparently. And I didn't know it was a thing, and apparently it is a thing. And there you go. But if you've got this far and you know what I'm talking about, you'll kind of know what I'm talking about. But if you haven't got this, I don't know if it's still available on vinyl anymore. It may have been limited, I'm not sure. But if you haven't, you can get it on CD, I'm sure. It's worth getting. It's worth getting. Hopefully that's convinced you it is. And absolutely beautiful. Loved it. Loved it, loved it, loved it. I'm looking forward to listening to side 4, which I will not be doing on camera because, you know, that's going to be another half hour of stuff and there'll be more things to listen to in due course. I kind of need to go and do stuff now. So anyway, that's that. I hope you enjoyed. And I'll see you all on the next video whenever and whatever that is. And until then, this is Jim over and out.